robots, they are doing a team task. So in this particular task, they have to move in the formation. So they have to move around while keeping the shape of the formation. They have to measure the distance relative to each other. And there are certain internal computations they have to carry out and use certain algorithms that we have developed. They use those algorithms to compute where they need to be in such a formation. They are intelligent and they are doing this autonomously without us as humans to interrupt.
Ming Chow is professor of networks and robotics at the University of Groningen. Chow is a pioneer in the development of bio-inspired operating systems, enabling groups of robots to carry out tasks independently.
There are a lot of autonomous technologies being developed. We are hearing about autonomous cars and autonomous robots. They're all possible applications of such technologies. Yeah, I'm an engineer. I'm doing my research following a multidisciplinary approach. So I collaborate a lot with mathematicians, biologists, and sociologists. For example, the algorithm that we have developed for those robots, part of it is inspired by how animals are moving around. We look into fish and birds, because fish, they usually, if they swim together, we conjecture there might be some efficiency for the way they move around. And if we want to design energy-efficient robots, then the robotic fish can learn from how the real fish swim. In the past, as engineers, we just design something for granted. We just let all those robots to collaborate. But we also learn that when the robots are able to make decisions by themselves, it's not natural for them to cooperate in certain scenarios. They might have conflicting interests. So we work with sociologists to see how humans, they develop such cooperative behavior and try to learn from human behavior and design rules for robots to work together.